Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to introduce the concept of transfer functions. So, we'll talk about what they are and what they're going to be used for in this control systems course. So, let's remember back to pre-calculus, when we were talking about functions. If you recall, they are an input to output relationship. So, we enter some input to our function and it transforms it into a specific output. Through such, we gain an understanding of how our function will react to all inputs. Well, transfer functions in control systems are very similar in that they take in an input and give us an output. Through such, our transfer function, which is a mathematical function, creates a theoretical model of some system which gives us an understanding of how our system will react to all possible inputs. These are used for linear time invariant systems, LTIs. However, there are a few special things that we need to talk about. So, in a transfer function, our input to-output relationship is in the Laplace domain, and all of the initial conditions are assumed to be zero. Just note that transfer functions are for linear, ordinary differential equations, and allow us to avoid complicated integration through the use of the Laplace domain. So, the way we represent transfer functions is like so. We have some input into our system, our transfer function of our system, and an output. Remember that we denote we are in the Laplace domain using capital variables, and that these functions are of our imagined variable s, as we are not in the time domain. Our transfer functions are basically just a ratio of polynomials. So, the transfer function is just a relationship between the input to the output. So, at its core, the transfer function tells us the output to input ratio. Just as a note, the bottom term is called our characteristic polynomial, and its roots decide where our poles will be located at. The roots of the top polynomial tell us where our function's zeros will be at. We will talk about this more in coming videos though. So, to solve these problems, we will be doing a lot of factoring, and I will post some more videos on helpful factoring techniques, such as partial fraction expansion. So, now that we have a fundamental understanding of what transfer functions are, let's walk through why we use transfer functions. We first begin in our time domain, which looks something like this. But this isn't easy to solve. However, through the Laplace transform, we can turn this into a simple algebraic problem. So, we flip over to the Laplace domain using our Laplace transform we talked about in previous videos. And as you can see, we are left with a simple algebraic relationship. We then solve for our missing component, whether that's the transfer function, the input, or the output. Then, we just take the inverse Laplace transform of this and return to the time domain with our answer. So, for example, if we wanted to study a reactor's temperature change with altering coolant flow rates, we could create a model for that. Then, our transfer function would tell us the ratio between our input change, that being the coolant change, versus the output, which is the reactor's temperature. So, in summary, we go to the Laplace domain and solve for our unknown, since it makes the math much easier. Then, we just bring the answer back with us to the time domain. In the next video, I'll prove that moving from the time domain to the Laplace domain and back to the time domain is the same as solving the whole thing in the time domain. It just makes everything much easier. Also, in the coming videos, we'll talk about the various types of transfer functions and go through more examples to ensure that you fully understand the concept. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of what transfer functions are. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.